Now, coming to the next topic under our today discussion is good practices using OER. So before going to start OER, this is actually a tentative class of planning. 5 minutes for attendance, 5 minutes for revision or mapping of last class, or just having revision. And today topics, what we are discussing with the subtopics on the board or on the online or in the PPT, neatly mention what you're discussing. Without a continuation of the previous class and today class, what you are going to discussing, if you are goes on continuous teaching, the student is not able to discuss, they are not catch it. In even in the online classes, it is mandatory how much good graphically represented the content. It's very easy, catchy to the students to listen and to attend the classes very interestingly. And 25 to 30 minutes is a lecture by the faculty. And 10 to 15 minutes is an activity will be there. We have a different activities, like the question answer, maybe have a thinking share, or maybe have a offline a quiz conducting with the have a form a teams, discussion among the students, or assign seminar on current topics like real-time scenarios, more examples, or maybe projects, or maybe a survey. Among this, if you conduct a class for a 15 minutes or 1 hour, then definitely is useful. Coming to the OER stands for Open Education Resources. Open educational resources, what we are using is like the most olden practice or now current practice as well, textbooks, the reference books, web links, NPTEL, the Swayam Prabha, ePathshala, YouTubes, and also we have an option in the YouTubes. Maybe how many of you are using, I don't know, the Creative Commons. In when you're searching for any videos in the YouTube, just type it, like for example, I required videos on the Android application development. It will show you a lot of videos. If you want to filter that one, there is an option called as Creative Commons. If you are giving a query videos on Android application development, it shows you thousands of videos. If you want to filter it for a 100 or 200, you say there is an option called as Creative Commons. And we also use the OER like Ishoda, which is a Sindhu, which is most of the PhDs, doctorates, all M.Tech thesis, the top universities, will be available, all the thesis documentations in infflipnet.ac.in, which is also called as Ishoda Sindhu. And we have the NDLI cloud and Drupal cloud as well. And don't forget, whatever the sources OERs you are going to using, don't directly use as it is. You please mention, because you are teaching in online, maybe we don't know how many are going to be watching this one. If you are sharing through the YouTube or sharing in the WhatsApp, it will goes one by one, like with the help of a community spread will be more. And maybe if anyone found that directly we are using without giving any courtesy of that material. So don't forget to give the courtesy. Even if you're taking from Google also, please give the courtesy to Google as well. And start, if you have a more experiences, don't forget to start writing of your own textbook and save your material up to date, because you're teaching online in the Google Drive, or maybe can you store your material in the Dropbox. We can store in OneDrive. These are the open storage clouds available to save your material whenever, wherever you go for teaching. This is a good practice when you are teaching for a particular topic. This is objective content outcome. So this is, for example, I'm taking a course called as software engineering, and this is the unit name as software engineering and software process. Under this, we are teaching a particular topic called as the nature of software engineering layers. For example, what are the resources details you are going to be, whether directly you are taking from textbook or from Google or from YouTube link or from any other source which you are taking for this presentation, and or maybe from Google Drive, which link it is. So please mention clearly where it is available, because it's online. Definitely we have to give the online resources in the form of a PPT, PDF, Word, whatever. So mention the resources already, which is already available, or similar materials are available. Now, what is your assessment details? Whether after listening this of class, whether you are giving any assignment, whether you are framing any 10 questions and you answers for this one, whether the student is catch or not. It is not the thing, just we are deliver the things. The rest of the thing has to be, student has to take care of. It's not like that. When you deliver a topic for a 15 minutes or 40 minutes, we have assess ourselves whether the student is catch or not. And in the online, we have only the tools, or like conducting a small poll in the online itself, or just conducting a small quiz, or giving some small sort of assignment and what it may be. So give and take the feedback so that you can assess yourself whether the topic is reached to the student level or not. Right. So one more thing is there, out of this one, a self-learning topics also we can assign, like in the form of assignments, like clean room software engineering process, we can do it. Similarly, for the other topics, we can also